Hello viewers, welcome to my channel TechInfoBoost. But before watching this video, please watch Learn CSS, Understand Basic Concept of CSS video on my YouTube TechInfoBoost channel. So today, in this video, we are going to learn about CSS border property. So for this demo, I have already created some external CSS file and one demo page. So let's open it. I'm going to use Visual Studio Code. If you check the path, it is C Apache 24 htdocs, which is a default path for placing your project on HTTP Apache web server. So in this Learn CSS folder, I have created another folder CSS. In this, I have placed learncss.css external stylesheet, and this is my demo learncss.php page. So let's open external stylesheet learncss.css file. Today we are going to learn about CSS border. So I have taken one p element whose color property is set to value blue violet. So now let's learn about border style property. The border style property specifies different border to display. The following values are allowed. First, double define a double border. Second, solid defines a solid border. Third, dashed defines a dashed border. Fourth, dotted defines a dotted border. Fifth, outset define a 3D outset border. The effect depends on the border color value. Sixth, inset defines a 3D inset border. The effect depends on the border color value. Reach defines a 3D ridge border. The effect depends on the border color value. Groove defines a 3D grooved border. The effect depends on the border color value. 9. None defines no border. 10. Hidden defines a hidden border. So in this external learncss.css file, I have defined some rule set of CSS. First, for this border property demo, I have taken p element as a selector and defined some classes. So the first class I have defined is learn border style property double, which contain two properties. Border style is set to value double and border width is set to 15 pixel value. Same I have done for solid, dash, dotted, outset, inset, ridge, groove, none, hidden. Now let's open web browser. You can see I am not connected to internet. Now open localhost /repository/learncss/learncss.php page. In learncss.php, I have taken an element and written text, let us learn about CSS border. So here you can see that text. Then I have taken h1 element and written text border style property. You can see this text border style property. Now I've taken p element and set the class attribute to learn border style property double, and I have written the text as border style property with double values. In the same way I have done for remaining border style property values, that is solid value, dashed value, dotted value, outside value, inset value, reach value, groove value, none value, and hidden value. Now if you see in learncss.php page, This is a border style property with double value. This is border style property with solid value. This is border style property with dashed value, and this is border style property with dotted value. This is border style property with outset value. This is border style property with inset value. So on this demo page you can see different styles of border style. This is border style property with reach value. Border style property with groove value. This is border style property with none value. There is no border present. This is border style property with hidden value. Here also border is hidden. Now let's go back to code. So here I have taken h1 element and written text as border color property. So here you can see this border color property text which I have written in h1 element. So after this I have taken one p tag whose class attribute is set to learn border color property. This is nothing but the CSS class which we have written in external style sheet, that is learn css.css. Now let us learn about border color property. The border color property is used to set the color of the four borders. The color can be set by first name, specify a color name like yellow. Second hex, specify hex value like #FFFF00. This represent yellow color. Third RGB, specify RGB value like RGB 255 255 0. This also represent yellow color. Fourth transparent. The border color property can have from 1 to 4 values. For the top border, right border, bottom border and the left border. If border color is not set, it inherits the color of the element. This is important to note that if border color is not set, it inherits the color of the element. So just we have seen that for border style property, we have not mentioned the color, but it has taken the color of the element which we have specified over here, blue violet. Okay, so this is a CSS class p dot learn border color property. Inside this I have taken two properties, border style which is set to solid value and border color which is set to yellow. Now go back to learncss.php page. So here is this class learn border color property and I have written the text border color property. Now let's go to page. Here you can see this is a border color property and the color of the border is yellow. Now let us learn about border width property. The border width property specifies the width of the four borders. The width can be set as a specific size or by using one of the three predefined values, thin, medium or thick. The border width property can have from 1 to 4 values. For the top border, right border, bottom border and the left border. So I have taken p dot learn border width property with predefined. Inside this I have taken two properties, border style is set to solid value and border width is set to medium value. Now go to learn css.php page. Here I have taken h1 element. Inside that I have written text border width property. So this is border width property which I have written inside h1 element. After that I have taken a p element whose class attribute is set to learn border width property with predefined. Inside this I have written the text border width property with predefined values. So you can see this is border width property with predefined values. We have set the value medium. Now let us change this medium value to thick value. Now go to learncss.php page. Here I am going to add thick word in this text. So the modified text is border width property with predefined thick values. Now go to file, click save button. Now go to learncss.php page, refresh it. Now you can see this is border width property with predefined values. Now go to learncss.css file and modify thick to thin. Now the modified text is border width property with predefined thin values. Go to file, click the save button. Now we have to refresh this page. I have taken h1 element and written the text border property with 4 values. So you can see this border property with 4 values. And then I have taken p element whose class attribute is set to learn border properties with 4 values and written the text border property with 4 values. Let's go in learncss.css file. Here I have taken one CSS class named as p.learnBorderProperties with 4 values. Inside this I have taken 3 properties. Border width property is set to value 2px, 4px, 6px and 8px. Border color property is set to black, red, green and blue. Border style property is set to solid, dotted, dashed, double. So each this value represent top border, right border, bottom border and the left border. So top border will be solid black and 2px. Right border will be dotted red, 4px. Bottom border will be dashed green, 6px. And the left border will be double blue, 8px. Now let's learn about this class p.learnBorderProperties with 3 values. Here also I have taken 3 properties, border width, border color and border style. Border width is set to value 2px, 6px and 10px. Border color property is set to black, green, blue value and border style property is set to solid, dotted and dashed value. And each this value represent top, right, left and bottom border. Now go back to learncss.php page. Here I have taken h1 element and written the text inside that border property with three values. Here you can see that text, border properties with three values. Then I have taken p element whose class attribute is set to learn border properties with three values, and inside that I have written the text border properties with three values. Now go to learncss.css file. So top border will be solid black 2 pixel. Here you can see that solid black 2 pixel border. Right and left border will be dotted green 6 pixel. So you can see this green dot over here for right and left border. And bottom border will be dashed blue 10 pixel. Now we are going to see p.learn border properties with two values CSS class. Here also I have defined three properties: border width, which is set to value 2 pixel 10 pixel, border color property, which is set to value red and green, and border style property is set to solid and dashed. And each value represent, first value represent top and bottom border, and the second value represent right and left border. Now go to learncss.php page. Here again I have taken h1 element whose text property is set to border property with two values, and I have taken p tag whose class attribute is set to learn border properties with two values, and the text written as border properties with two values. So top and bottom border will be solid red 2 pixel. So you can see this top and bottom border is solid red 2 pixel, and right and left border will be dash green 10 pixel. So you can see this right and left border is dash green color. In p.border property with one values CSS class, I have taken three properties: border width is set to 6 pixel, border color is set to blue, and border style is set to dashed. Now go to learncss.php page. Here I have taken h1 element and written the text border property with one values. Then I have taken a p element whose class attribute is set to learn border properties with one value. Inside that I have written the text border properties with one values. So this is text border properties with one values inside the h1 element, and this is a text border property with one values inside p element. Now all the borders will be dash blue 6 pixel. So here you can see that all the borders are blue dash 6 pixel. Now let us learn about border individual sides. In CSS, there are also properties for specifying each of the borders: top, right, bottom, and left. We have to make a note that none of the other CSS border properties described below will have any effect unless the border style property is set. For showing this, I have defined a class p.learn border properties with individual sides. This class contains border top style, which is set to dotted value, border right style is set to solid, border bottom style is set to dash, border left style is set to double, border top width property is set to 10 pixel, border right width property is set to 20 pixel, border bottom width property is set to 30 pixel, border left width is set to 40 pixel. So for individual sides we are setting all these properties. Then border top color is set to black, border right color is set to red, border bottom color is set to green, border left color is set to blue. So in this way we have set individual sides of border with different properties. Now go to learn css.php page. So I have taken h1 element, inside that I have written the text border individual sides. After that I have taken p element, whose class attribute is set to learn border properties with individual sides, and I have written the text border style property with individual sides set to different values. So this is the text which we have written inside the h1 element, border individual sides. Now go to learn css.css file. Now the border top style will be dotted 10 pixel and black color. So you can see this is a dotted black color. Right border will be solid 20 pixel and red. So this is solid and red. Bottom border will be dashed 30 pixel and green. So this is dash and green border, and the left border will be double 40 pixel and blue. So you can see this is a blue color for left border. So in this way we can set individual sides of the border. Now let us learn about border radius property. The border radius property is used to add rounded borders to an element. Please make a note that the border radius property is not supported in IE8 and earlier versions. So for showing this, I have defined a class p.learnBorderRadius property. This class contains two properties. Border is set to 4 pixel space solid space red, and border radius is set to 5 pixel. Now go to learn css.php page. So this is h1 element, inside that I have written the text border radius property. Then I taken p element, whose class attribute is set to learn border radius property value. And inside that I have written the text border radius property. So you can see that border corners are rounded due to this border radius property. Now let us learn about CSS border property. The CSS border property allow us to specify the style, width and color of an element's border. The border property is a shorthand property for the following individual border properties. First, border width. Second, border style. This is required. Third, border color. For this, I have defined p.learnBorderProperty class. Inside this, I have defined property border, whose value is set to 10 pixel space solid space yellow. This is h1 element, inside that I have written the text CSS border property. Then I have taken p element, whose class attribute is set to learn border property. Inside that I have written the text border property. So you can see this is CSS border property text which I have written inside the h1 element, and this is border property text which I have written inside p element. You can also specify all the individual border property for just one side. For this I have taken p.learnBorderProperty with just one side CSS class, which contain borderLeft property whose value is set to 6 pixels solid red. For this, I have taken p element whose class attribute is set to learnBorderProperty with just one side, and I have written the text borderProperty with just one side. So we have just set left border. So you can see this is just left border with red color.
Thanks for watching my video. Please like, share and subscribe my channel so that you get a notification for my new videos.